Welcome you all to this webinar on defect analysis. And today we have Mr. A.M. Deshpande sir with us. He's a foundry consultant having more than 35 years experience in foundry. And he's with us. He's specialized in development and defect analysis. He's a lot of experience in that particular fields. So welcome you all on behalf of German Corporation, Massia and Dynamic Foundry Group and GIZ. So welcome you all participants, and I request A.M. Deshpande sir to introduce himself and start the presentation. Yes, sir. Screen is visible to everybody. Deshpande sir.
Friends, myself Deshpande. I am very much thankful of the organization Massia, Mr. Yogesh Tavde, for giving me the opportunity to do my presentation in front of you all. So we'll start now. In Greco-Italian or Aegean foundry, rejection is most important criteria to control the profitability and performance of the organization. So understanding the defects and remedies, that is today's topic. In a foundry, major rejection is always of blowholes, but we'll see different types of blowholes in this presentation. Surface blowholes, pinholes, then nitrogen fissure, like that. One by one, we'll see. On left hand side, you can see the blowhole, which is shown near the number 12. And near to that, you can see the flow off. The flow up doesn't came up to the full height. So these blowholes are due to less metal temperature. On the right hand side, you can see blowholes due to high moisture in sand. These are the actual photographs taken by me. Next slide. Left hand side, bubbles over the complete surface of gray and casting and the microstructure of the area of pinhole. Next. Slag also gives the blowhole, slag plus blowhole. Typical appearance is shown of the microstructure. Because that graphite film and particle decarburation of the surface zone. You can see it clearly. Personally, I have seen this type of micro. In ductile iron, something will be different. Flakes will be there around the defect zone. But it is in the, this is in the gray cast iron. Slag and blowhole. Or blowhole due to slag. This is typically hydrogen pinhole. That is because of hydrogen pinhole means because of excess water in the sand. You can see the round graphite film inside it, but outside of the defect is perfectly round and it is having shining. Just like a moon, we can say, but inside is a black one. It is a typical hydrogen pinhole revealing in the graphite lining. Next slide. This is the nitrogen fissure. You can see it clearly where the defect is. Adjacent to the defect area, flakes are not there. There is some gap between the defect and flakes. This is typically because of nitrogen content. Nitrogen levels, what it has to be kept, that I have given in the presentation. But in case of ductile iron, basically, the same thing will happen. In case of near to defect, there will not be the ductile iron small round, what you say, nodule counter, nodules, we can say, nodules which are not present, nodules not present around the defect, as we are seeing the defect in cast iron. Because of nitrogen, appearance of the defect and the graphite, both are same in both the gray iron and ductile iron. Next slide. These are the surface blowholes which are revealed after machining. Normally, this type of blowholes are found in ductile iron, basically. Bunch of small blowholes having diameter about 1.5 mm, 2 mm only. But bunches of blowholes, at least 10 to 15 small blowholes will be there. Maybe seen after machining. That is a typically. Remedy is also given in my presentation. Next slide. These are the typically to avoid the gas entrapment or to release the gases of shell core. Especially shell core, which have the gas content around 20 cc, anything above 18 to 25 cc as per resin content and STS. For perfect sealing, these type of sealing rings or pipes are to be used for the better vent sealing, so that metal will not enter in core. It is always core gases. To avoid this type of can be used, especially jacket cores in cylinder head and cylinder block. Next slide. Next slide. These are typical examples given. This is the water jacket of four cylinder block. On the right hand, you can see the vent tube is there and vent sealing ring is also there. White one is the vent sealing ring. On left hand side also, that has been shown. Metallic vent tube on cope side, water jacket opening. Drilling has to be done. Then all the vents are to be properly sealed as per the two. These are the white one what you are seeing. To avoid metal into the jacket core vents, these are the white one which are kept. That those are getting pressed after box closing and clamping, so that metal will not enter in the way. Asbestos washer on drag mold and cope mold also. White one, what I am saying is, these are the asbestos washer, readily available from 6 mm diameter to 12 mm or 18 mm diameter. So that it will get pressed and 100% metal not enter in. It must, because jacket core hot tensile strength and
room temperature would be around 1450 and 1440. At least 1440 for the first box. Last box will be around 1410. So the material will have the good quality to enter in four vents, and this has to be avoided by using this type of vents and plugs. These plugs are also available in diameter 4 mm, 6 mm, 8 mm. These are of MS. MS is we'll have the temperature around 49. So MS will not get melted. So all the gases from core will go to the atmosphere and those will not come in. Which is the most important.
Deshpande sir, there is a disturbance in voice.
Why? थोड़ा मोटा करो क्या?
हाँ थोड़ा मोटा पन करा
मोटा कर तो नहीं तो मुंह में जागा थोड़ा है बाकी क्या रहा है कोई थोड़ा स्पेशल सी है कमीज़ सोता क्या फुटपो
है कमीज़ सोता है फुटपो इधर
वॉइस इज ब्रेकिंग
नेटवर्क नेटवर्क सा में भी प्रॉब्लम
है तो प्रॉब्लम है आई विल गो इन सम अदर या 2 मिनट्स
यस दैट इज बेटर
हेलो
Yes,
now it's clear. Hello?
Yes, Hello? It is clear now.
Yeah, yeah. This is the typical four-cylinder water jacket core and venting. Typically, I have shown, which is as asbestos washer on the horizontal face. This has to be kept basically to avoid metal entry. From metal entry to the core vent, normally we keep the clearance between pattern print and core print height-wise at least 1 mm to accommodate the various process variations of core assembly and cold assembly. So 1 mm clearance may take metal into the core vent, so that if we put asbestos washer of 8 mm, 10 mm, 12 mm diameters are available. And thickness will be 1 to 1.5 mm so that after clamping the perfect sealing will be there, metal will not enter. In spite of that, normally we keep the vent metallic vent tube on cope side of water jacket opening. These are purposely kept basically metallic, that is the these are made from MS. Melting point of MS is 1526 degrees centigrade, and metal what we reach here is around 1350. So that metallic vent tube will not melt due to the metal contact, and all the gases, core gases, will pass through the atmosphere. So it is most important because of these are the shell cores. Shell cores thickness of shell core is around 5 mm. Especially in the, this type of cores, and those cores are having hot tensile strength up to 35 kg per cm square, and transverse strength around 70 to 80 kg per cm square. Because of these, the amount of gas which will be delivered will be around 20 cc. Hence, this is must to avoid the blowhole rejection, especially for the blockade. Or critically core castings. Now it is clear, na gentlemen. Sorry for the disturbance. Kulkarni put the next slide. These are another examples which are given: water jacket core, mold vent, asbestos washer. Next slide, please. Now it is a bigger view: metallic core vent, mold vent, water jacket core vent, water jacket core. It is a section of a four-cylinder block, water jacket cylinder block for the cars, especially cars and some other engines, basically. But water jacket cylinder block is the most critical item in a foundry, and this is required will be always per day 100 or per day 150. So that this type of care is a must. Next slide, please. This photograph shows basically assembly of four cylinder blocks, barrel core, then jacket core and cores. We can see the venting also, barrel core venting is taken from the bottom side. Core, cold metal is taken also to avoid the gases on head face. Next slide. Blow holes typically, reason of blow holes basically pouring temperature less, time holding of metal, check with pouring workers, what was observation, spurting noticed, interrupted pouring happened or not, check chemistry, hardness, micro rejected casting in defective zone. These are the normal guideline given. If blow holes are rejection of blowholes, if goes from 2% to 10%, 20%, all these are the steps to be followed. That's why number of steps I given, pouring time, temperature, holding of metal. Normally in a foundry, worker is most important person because he knows every day pouring and yesterday pouring or specifically on that day, what has gone wrong. He can say correctly. Then spurting, interrupted pouring, check chemistry, hardness, micro, sand properties. These are the, for blowhole analysis, these are the, all the things are to be studied. My request will be, don't go bias-minded, but complete thorough analysis is important. That has to be done. That's why these are the points are global for analysis purpose. Next slide. These are the characteristic features of blow holes, individual or group of cavities, mostly large with smooth walls, incidence gases entrapped by solidifying the metal on the surface of the casting, which result in a rounded or oval blow as a cavity, frequently associated with the slag or oxides. The defects are nearly always located in the cope box, cope part of the mold, and poorly vented pockets and undercut. The formation of blow holes is more intensive with gray iron casting than AGIN. These are the possible causes. If resin bonded sand, core venting is not enough, release of gas, core, then moisture absorption by the cores too great, and too low gas permeability of core sand. These are the possible clauses, but what I have given above, that has to be analyzed with this, this is the guideline given to you. Next slide. If it is a clay bonded sand, moisture content of the sand too high, water released, gas permeability of the sand too low, sand temperature, bentonite too high. These all related with the green sand. Too much gas released from the lustrous carbon producer, then compaction with the mold too high, gating and pouring traces, casting temperature too low, metallostatic pressure too low when pouring. Metallostatic pressure means basically your system should be full while critically pouring the casting. System should be full, and on the highest point of a casting, at least 3-inch pouring head should be there. Highest point of a casting, on that above 3-inch sand or 4-inch sand should be there, and system should be full. So that due to metallostatic pressure, all the gases will pass easily. If metallostatic pressure is not there, the release of gases will be at low speed, and chances of blow holes are very much there. I
given one example in a case study of this particular aspect. Next slide, please. These are the remedies. Pouring time and temperature has to be as per AFS Getting and Rising Handbook. I have given the example in the case study. Pouring head compactability to be maintained as per ambient condition. Compactability means in if it is a then you have to maintain the compactability for high pressure molding lines around 36-34 to 40. But in case of upper molding lines, it should be around 38-42 as per foundry to foundry practice. And mold vent area to be kept 2-3 times of choke area, especially when casting weight and mold casting weight and core weight is almost same, or core weight always weight of core is 50% of casting, the amount of gas generated will be high mold and core. Hence vent area should be at least 2-3 times than choke area. This is most important for HPML flask, HPML design HPML flask. No, without flask molding lines are there. For that molding line, direct vents on casting are not permissible. Hence, to release the gases, 0.2 mm thick and 30 mm strips to be provided at the parting, so that all the parting line gases will be removed. Then core gases to be taken out by proper vent connection and sealing of vents. That already I have told you. Core gas and core use of mandrel to reduce wet core and sealing of hollow portion of with gap core or cover core, we can say. Shell core gases, proper venting and sealing. That is already I have shown elaborately. So these are the most important points for the to remedies to avoid the blowholes. Next slide. Now this is the typical example I have given. Basically, you can see it. See all the vents are there. Running system. This is the bunch of the casting. That this casting is having weight 76 kg and weight of core is 65 kg, but it is a cold box core. But height of the casting from parting line is around 250 mm. Height of casting from parting line is around 250 mm, and height of box is 325 mm. So 75 mm above the highest point of the casting, you can see the height of the floors. That from that you can understand. ARPA molding line, HPML molding line, I have given the guideline basically. Summer, winter, rainy, then green compression and permeability, and core gas evolution. 1 g/cc. If you take a sample of core 1 g without paint, normally if we take with paint, the criteria will be different. If we take the core gases at 980 degrees centigrade for cold box core, around 10-12 cc gases are there. Shell core 15-30 cc as per loss on ignition and typical use of particular core, jacket core, then barrel core, then blowby core, or in case of hydraulics, the thickness of core will be around 8 mm, 10 mm maximum. But metal static pressure is more for hydraulic castings also. In that case also, the amount of gas will be around 25-30 cc for shell core. Of course, nowadays good quality of shell sand is available in the market. HTS around 35, CTS around 90, but gas will be around 20 cc. These are available in the market. Technology of producing shell core is
nowadays very good. Norbit core 10cc normal addition means in normally for Norbit core what happens during the winter because of ambient temperature less, the reaction of resin doesn't take place below 35 degree centigrade and ambient temperature will be around maximum 20 degree centigrade. And normally what worker they do, they add more resin and hardener. Due to that, gas will, amount of gases will be increased. That's why I said ki normal addition. But we have to take care of Muller operator. We have to give the proper instruction to the Muller operator. Then CO2 core 6 to 8 cc. And please note, molding sand of 1 cc of water use 17.4 cc gas at pouring temperature 1350 degree centigrade. So we have to maintain the moisture level of our system sand, green sand, optimal level so that mold should not be get fried or dried. Mold should come, but amount of water, we should have a control on compactability is most important. Basically, in a foundry, patterns which are having self-core zone height more at that time, especially in ARPA molding line, worker molding that mold shop worker or machine operator give instruction to the sand fan man to add more water so that there will not be rejection of mold broken. Number of molds per hour, he can manage it. But he will manage the number of molds, but we have to face the rejection. So we have to take care and instruct the sand plant operator also, and frequent checking also is important. Because I have shown now 1 cc of water gives 17.4 cc of gas at pouring temperature this much. So if we add more water, rejection of blowhole is going to increase. That is sure. That's why elaborately all the exact figures are given by me as a ready reference. So I request to use all these figures in our practically. Next slide, please. And here particularly we, I have given the example of sieve distribution. Now you can see fines which are there, 140 mesh, 200 mesh, 300 mesh. CV distribution is purposely given so that we can get correct amount of, this is a dry sand sieve distribution. Typically, it has to be used for the cold box core. Typically, it has to be used for cold box core. So that with optimum resin percentage, we can get good scratch hardness and also finish of a good finish of a core. Pore sieve distribution. Yes. Next slide, please. This is also percentage retention on system sand. This is the, these are the actual figures in the reputed foundry. As an example, I have given, you can use it. Next slide. Sieve distribution. Single peak sand. Next slide. Now we'll go to the, we have seen the blowhole. It is now we'll go the pinholes. These are the pinholes appeared normally, but it is for gray iron or ductile. But in case of ductile iron, these are more. Next slide. It is related with the moisture, pouring time, temperature. That graphite film also comes because this is because of the slag and yeah. One thing I would like to tell, because normally keep the filter and still we say we get sometimes slag reaction.
but this slag rejection is basically due to the improper condition of pouring ladle and tapping ladle, bull ladle or pouring ladle, we can see. So in spout area, if continuous pouring is there, in spout area, slag gets deposited. In case of AGN, after 25 or 30 hits, the treatment ladle will have more slag in the spout area, and that is a liquid slag basically. When we pour the metal, the slag near the spout that goes along the with metal in the system or in the casting also, that liquid slag cannot be controlled by filter. Filter can control the solid slag. Slag which is perfectly not removed from the slag can be interrupted or taken care of by using foam filter, but liquid slag will go from the filter also. So we have to see that our pouring ladle and treatment ladle, especially spout area, slag, if it is deposited, that has to be removed or relining has to be done. Normally, it is not taken care of. That is my personal observation. In a day, at least 30-40, if we do ductile end treatment at a time, in a one day, then at that time, first 25 or 30, 25 hits, no problem will be there. But after that, this problem will come. So this is the typical example of a slag blowhole. These are the explanation given for the pinholes. Pinhole can appear individually or in area. Then especially CO, that carbon monoxide slag reaction only occur, that what I have explained in ductile iron because of slag, or in gray iron also, if slag is not removed properly, that CO slag reaction only occur in gray iron casting. CO slag relation have a smooth surface, the size of surface. These are explanation given. So you can correlate with the defect by seeing the microstructure. Additional explanations are given. Dorik Pude. These are hydrogen and nitrogen blowholes. These are the possible causes. Now we will come to the nitrogen content in the melt too high. Normally, nitrogen comes from the shale sand, then shale sand and CPC, calcine petroleum coke. In a foundry, at least in gray iron, normally what happens, if the charge calculation or weighment is not done properly, then if you take a cup, the base metal carbon will come to 3 or 3.1%. And to increase 0.2% of carbon, we have to add the CPC. Then if we add CPC late addition of CPC gives nitrogen. That's why late addition of CPC has to be avoided, or charge calculation has to be done perfect so that the carbon and silicon values, what we are expecting, not 5%, it should go above level, so that 50 kg MS or CRC has to be added, so that late addition of CPC or carbon has to be avoided, because that carbon doesn't mix fully. Otherwise, if we want to do it, then we have to tap out the metal. 50% metal has to be tapped out from the furnace, and that metal has to be put in the furnace. But ultimately, this activity will take at least 5 minutes, and amount of metal per day or per shift, that will be less. So that charge calculation has to be done perfectly. Late addition of CPC has to be avoided. Nitrogen comes from the shale sand also. Shale sand, in we add resin and hexamine. Hexamine has to be added 18% of the resin. 18% of the resin. If 3.5% is the resin addition in chamber kg, 100 kg, then 18% of resin hexa has to be added. But the operator who is operating the shell sand muller is not that much aware. He may add some hexa more. So if hexa added is more, then we get the amine, nitrogen fissure, in especially for the shell core area. Those are observed in shell core area. Then in Kolbos area, Kolbos core, the nitrogen content is too low. But in case of, there are main two sources of nitrogen, CPC and shell core, as far as my experience is concerned. Then resin bonded sand, nitrogen nitrogen compound. These are the possible causes are given. But mind well, to avoid the nitrogen fissure, these taken, care has to be taken. Next slide, please. Now, getting and pouring practice. Pouring passages too long, too much turbulence and slug formation during pouring. Or metallurgical, these are the possible causes which are given, getting and pouring. Then metallurgy, huge charge components lead with low nitrogen, reduced quantity of steel scrap, used scrap and return material free of dust, water, oil impurities, then free of adhering sand, use of charge material, standard charge material, aluminum, titanium in case of HN, deoxidized metal as well as possible. Avoid excessive supply of titanium and aluminum. These are the possible causes, but we have to analyze it properly, which are the guidelines which I have given. According to, you have to analyze it. First, see the micro. Here, then we can definitely we can have the right idea. Next slide. This is the repeated from earlier slide only. The next slide, please. These are the typical avoidance of hydrogen phenols due to carbon monoxide slag reaction. Low viscosity slag rich in manganese oxide and enriched with manganese sulfide. हे झाले की जरा जर इकडे चालते हे नायट्रोजन फिशर ऑल्सो आय एक्सप्लेन. These are the additional theory. Pinholes, ductile iron, in ductile iron, especially defect observed in the zone away from ingate, add or one or two ingate as per geometry and weight of casting. Pouring time and temperature has to be increased as per the calculation and but best practice we can do it, so that ductile iron has to pour in a fast way. In cast iron, if we pouring time is increased by 5 to 10 seconds, that doesn't matter. But in ductile iron, pouring has to be done fast. Always use filter, no choke, then number of ingates to be added, and pouring has to be done fast in case of ductile iron, so that pinholes after machining or in ascash condition, those will be avoided. Then earlier what I have said, that pouring temperature, liquid slag entering in casting through treatment ladle or pouring ladle, then treatment ladle has to be changed immediately. As a practice, 25 to 30 treatments ladle to be changed. It will depend upon base sulfur also. Normally in foundry to foundry it varies. If base sulfur is not 2.5 or not 3, then slag generation will be more. If base sulfur in many foundries, if we control on CRC and other charging material, then base sulfur will be around 0.18 or above, below 0.2%. At that time, amount of slag generated will be less. So that's why I said ki, आणि कोल्ड बॉस कोर इन मॉन्सून गिव्स दिस प्रॉब्लेम. हा दिस इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट. कोल्ड बॉस कोर इन मॉन्सून गिव्स स्मॉल पिन होल्स. बेसिकली कोल्ड बॉस कोर इट्स अ हायग्रोस्कोपिक, इट ऍब्सॉर्ब द मॉइस्चर. देन दिस टाइप ऑफ डिफेक्ट पर्सनली आय हॅव फेस्ड इन मेनी कास्टिंग. विच आर पॉसिबल आय कन्वर्टेड कोल्ड बॉस कोर इन टू शेल कोर. देन we reduce the rejection from at least 7% to 0.5% only by changing the cold boss core to shell core. Of course the weight of core was less, around 5 to 6 kg weight of the core was there. Then we get the benefit from the rejection. If the cost of core, normally cold boss core cost will be rupees 12 to 13 per kg and shell core will be around 18 rupees per kg. But if we save on the rejection, that is going to give us the profit, or bottom line will be increased. So pinhole now it is cracks in gray and micrograph of formation of nitrogen. These are the typical photographs of nitrogen pinholes ISN. And micro photo also I explained. Next slide. Typical nitrogen fissure, mostly narrow crack like cavities. Crack like cavity in a typically fissure, narrow crack like cavity, but often run perpendicular to the casting surface. The interior of the cavity is predominantly dendritic. The surface of the cracks is not so shiny as they found with the hydrogen pinholes, and the defect can be several millimeters, where there is an extremely high nitrogen content. Nitrogen content should be maximum 80 ppm. Actually, as per the AFS or some other people, they say ki around 60 ppm, but as per my experience, if 80 ppm is there or 100 ppm is there, then the nitrogen fissure comes. So I have analyzed with Yelka lab also 2-3 times. Blowhole nitrogen fissure, that particular piece, microstructure piece, I send it to Yelka lab and got the report. That microstructure having nitrogen fissure, about 120 or 110 ppm was the nitrogen content. Incidence of the defect, that has been here. Yeah, put here, this regarding nitrogen fission, I have said much explanation is what I feel it is given. Microscope graph, gray and casting, interdendritic microlithic influence through the liberated gases. पुढचे केस नाही, नायट्रोजन पिशरच आहे सुद्धा. हां ते पुढचं नाही, त्याच्या पुढचं घ्या ना ते. हां त्याच्या अलीकडचं, त्याच्यात नायट्रोजन पिशरची व्हॅल्यू दिली बघ मी 80 पीपी. हां check nitrogen from casting or coin value. It if more 80 ppm, then check micro of defect region, which should be as per above the program. In case of cast gray cast iron ferrotitanium, if we get final value 0.4 to 0.5, which neutralize the effect of nitrogen. Addition of ferrotitanium normally in our melt up to 0.15 or 0.2 titanium will be there. If we add balance ferrotitanium, so that final value of titanium should be 0.4 to 0.5%, which neutralize the effect of nitrogen. That is a standard practice that can be adopted. Some of the people say ki if we add the titanium, then we may have the possibility of getting carbide, but to the best of my knowledge, at least I have not experienced it. Basically, if we add in because that the titanium effect in with zirconium type of inoculant that decentralize the air and will not have any problem while machining. Please note this. Avoid late addition of CPC in case of pastime. Charge mix charge calculation should be such that late addition of steel will be required and not carburized. And cold boss or no bag resin also give nitrogen rarely. I said rarely, but shell sand, at least in my career, I have seen at least 10 times or 20 times. I right from 2005 to up to now 15 years, I am doing this technical consultancy. At least 10 to 15 times, I requested shell sand manufacturer to control the addition of hexamine. And we able to solve the problem by adding titanium and changing the shell sand. And in case of CPC, CPC has to be stopped for late addition of CPC has to be stopped. Nowadays, graphite petroleum core of equal good quality is available that can be used for the late addition of carburizer. But CPC has to be avoided. हे झालं की हा आय थिंक आय हर्ड अबाउट द ब्लो होल्स पिन होल ब्लो होल फिशर देन स्लॅग ब्लो होल देन कार्बन मोनॉक्साईड ब्लो होल ऑल दीज टाईप ऑफ ब्लो होल्स आर देअर दीज आर इलॅबोरेटली आय एक्सप्लेन बिकॉज नॉर्मली वॉट हॅपन्स बेसिकली ब्लो होल्स आर इन्क्रीज check moisture, check for temperature, general random instruction we give. But these are in detail I have given the instructions or remedies in a theoretical way and analysis has to be done perfectly. These are the steps what I have given. Now we'll go to the second defect coming because of sand and methoding. This is the expansion cap on the top part of the large surface of gray end casting and rat tail also in upper part of gray end casting adjacent to the ingot. Scab is a rough irregular projection on the surface of a casting, sometimes containing embedded sand. All common ferrous and non-ferrous casting are these defects. Scabs are of two types, erosion scab and expansion scab. Erosion scab occurs when the metal is agitated, boiled or eroded by the sand, leaving a solid mass of sand which and metal which forms a, this is the description. Next slide. These are the causes, part of mold removed by metal stream. Part of mold removed by metal stream means if minor undercut is there in ingate area or in front of ingate area, minor undercut is there, then mold will come. But due to metal pressure, that sand will flow away. Expansion and subsequent buckling of thin layer of dried and heated sand on mold surface. No deformation characteristic, high thermal expansion sand here. Localized hydramine. These are the possible causes. Improper and gating and risering means basic metal distribution not proper, a number of ingates. Then pouring time. Most important is as per the geometry and weight. And geometry and weight specifically what I said. If 40 kg flywheel is there and 40 kg housing is there, housing will have more cores, but general wall will be less, 6 mm to 8 mm. Surface area will be more, height will be more, weight, though weight is 40 kg, that at that time we had to calculate the pouring time. I given the example in case study, pouring time. So improper gating means pouring time should be there, metal distribution should be there. Then ratio, pressurized or non-pressurized. So all these things are to be taken care of while designing the gating system in development stage only. Improper gating and risering. थोड़ा मागच जाऊ दे मागची मागची स्लाइड नाही त्याच्या हा इम्प्रॉपर यूज ऑफ व्हेरी फॅन फाईन शॅट विथ मॉइस्चर कंटेंट अँड लो परमिएबिलिटी एक्सेसिव्ह बाइंडर एक्सेसिव्ह पोरिंग टेम्परेचर दीज आर ऑल्सो कॉजेस फॉर द रेड टेल आता जो नेक्स्ट टाइम very fine sand means AFSU distribution has to be checked. Expansion cap, thin rough layers of metal partially separated from the body of a casting by thin layer of sand are known as expansion cap. Appear indentation on the casting. These are all buckles also known as. This defect is common aluminum and gray castings. Next. Rat tail is minor form of expansion defect occurring as a project. Defective design, large flat surface, sharp corners, uneven and hard running, inadequate gating, use of sand with high moisture content, low clay content. I can basically, you know, sand basically in sand properties, what we are maintaining, active clay, dead clay, loss on ignition, volatile matter, these are to be kept in a right way so that there will not be any problems, because we have to give the sufficient space for expansion. Normally that lustrous carbon and other additives are there, those are using wood sawdust in their product, that create the space for the expansion of a sand grain. So volatile matter, loss on ignition, compactability, AFS, CU distribution, all these are to be taken care of. Pouring temperature, time, venting. बस मागच बरोबर येते त्याच्या अगोदर आता दाखवलेलं नंतर. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. हा दीज आर द डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्कॅप ऑर ब्रीफ एक्सप्लेनेशन आय कॅन से. स्क्रॅप आर टिपिकली बेंटोनाइट सँडर. नॉर्मली नाउ डेज इन ग्रीन सँड वी मेंटेन द वेट टेन्साइल स्ट्रेंथ. दिस इज मच यूजफुल to control the expansion cap. At least wet tensile should be around 22 to 26. It should be 22 to 26. If it is less than 20, then that problem comes. And to avoid that, nowadays lot of variety of bentonite is available. MB value from 380 or around 420 or 400. If MB value is around 400, that gives more wet tensile strength up to 30. So choice of a bentonite or use of bentonite, correct quality bentonite, is also important to get good quality of green compression strength, but with optimum use of bentonite. If we add bentonite, then we have to add more water. Then amount of gases generated in the mold will be more. And it wet tensile has to be achieved at least 22, what I have said. Next. In India, what we are using is our calcium-based bentonite. But Nowadays, sodium-based bentonite is also available. That is very good as far as the sand properties are concerned, especially for the scab or sand erosion. That is avoided in that type of bentonite, sodium-based bentonite. These are the explanation given. These are the remedies I have given. Expansions of increased number of ingates, do proper metal distribution, calculate pouring time as per any standard group, maintain pouring temperature optimum considering respective foundry practice. Considering respective foundry practice means basically in a foundry sometimes pouring station is molding box distance from furnace to molding box. Sometimes it is more. At that time, they have to take more temperature. But in case some foundries, it is near. So accordingly, they have to choose the pouring temperature, optimum word that specifically I have mentioned. To be kept on lower side to avoid the cold shed blowhole after machining. Now, if we avoid the scab and if we get the blowhole, that is also not avoided, not useful. That's why I kept. To achieve that pouring time, if you correct the pouring time temperature, that helps. I request basically, I have given the pouring time calculation in my case study. My request will be use that particular book, AFS book, so that you can get the optimum pouring time, optimum choke area and metal distribution, so that all these type of defects will be avoided. Blowholes will be avoided. At the time, scabbing will be avoided. Pouring temperature and time are most important things. Because if you increase the pouring time temperature, then ultimately power cost or melting cost will be high. Lining life, all the things are there. So pouring temperature has to be bare minimum, but pouring time has to be controlled or to be kept as per the by using AFS book. If you maintain correct pouring time, that reduces much problems in the foundry stage reaction plus machining stage reaction. Then green compressions to be increased as per molding practice. Wet tensile strength, check pH value of a sand. This is most important. The pH is less, 7.5. That also gives the scab. Then we have to add soda to maintain pH 8 to 9. This is also important, basically. Check AFS sieve distribution such that it should be single prick. Fines to be kept minimum. Increase addition of coal compound. If you add coal compound, the surface finish of the casting will be improved and there will be space for the sand grains to expand. So that scabbing will not be there. Next slide. And this is no other defective slag inclusion. Slag on the top, you can see, if you see the left slag on the top part of gray and casting, in some cases still there, and other is already removed by short blasting. This is a typical microstructure. In case of ductile or iron also, if we see the microstructure of slag in slag zone, around the slag zone, flakes will be there. In case of ductile iron, if you see the micro of slag prone area, then flakes will be there around the defect. And in the right hand photo, we can see the color of the photo. Bottle green, what we say, slag should have the bottle green. That bottle green is also seen in the photo. Slag inclusions and gas defects under the surface of gray and casting inclusion caused by turbulence. Slag, so because of turbulence, slag enters the casting. Next slide.
This is typically, you can say, the slag and fusion photo. This is the actual photo taken from casting. This is the micrograph of slag zone. Now you can see in this microstructure photo, flakes are there. Micrograph of slag zone in the HGIN casting. Turbulence and oxidizing the atmosphere leads to linear shifted slag inclusion in the surface area, and you can see the flakes also. Characteristic features. It's a definition. Slag is not only found at the microstructure grain boundaries but also on the surface of a casting. Slag may often appear in association with gas cavities. Highly viscous slag more frequently appear in the microstructure of the casting. Low viscosity slags rises more quickly to the surface of the casting. Turbulence, oxidation, penetration, CO. These are the and correct definition of the defects are given. Each word is important, but it's written over here. Slag and oxides occur when melting metals. Oxygen promote the formation of oxides. During melting, these frequently react with the furnace or ladle lining. Ladle lining. When melting in gray casting, in cupola, the oxide generator also react with the ash residues from pit coal coke, and most cases results in the silicate. Metallurgical explanation: oxide content in too high impurity levels of oxide and hydrogen charged materials, poor or too dissolution of inoculants, ladle lining too highly reactive, poor deslagging of molten metal. Sorry, gentlemen, I have the some network problem. That's why sometimes. Range is there, sometimes range is not clear. That's why this is happening. Poor deslagging also is reason. Next, gating and pouring practice. Casting temperature too low and pouring too slow, too much turbulence. These are already I explained. Dry ladle prior to use, cold metal in the ladle. Remedy is what I say. Keep elements which strongly react with oxygen as low as possible. Aluminium, magnesium. There are reduce them. Use materials without impurities. Optimum use of inoculant. Avoid slagging in case of failure of dissolve. Reduce grain or size or not. Do not inoculate it. Dry ladle prior to use. Hold a metal in the ladle for shortest possible time and avoid allowing in the ladle. Skim ladles carefully. Use slag binders. If necessary, use T-spout ladle. Nowadays, everybody using T-spout ladle. Next. These are the explanation. Non-metallic inclusion. Put it again. Next. These are also explained. Next. Use that cold and dirty charge material. Remedies is already given. Next. If ingate thickness to be reduced 4 mm, especially in case of non-pressurized gating, thickness of ingate should not be more than 3 mm. It should be 3 to 3.5 mm so that slag will not enter. Use of strainer for home filters 20 ppi for CI, 20 ppi for CI, 10 ppi for ductile iron. And mind well, or please note that in case of ductile iron, what we are using the filter, foam filter. Each foam filter, as per the size, filtration capacity is given.
suppose if you take a filter, home filter, 50 by 50 by 15, then filtration capacity of that particular filter is around maximum 30 kg. If you pour 50 kg casting by using 50, 50, 15 filter, then pouring time will be high. And sometimes the pouring will be stopped, or first 10 seconds metal will go. After 10 seconds, that filter will get choked and metal will not pass. So while selecting or designing the gating system, filtration capacity has to be studied in case of ductile iron. Please remember. This is a typical example which I have given. You can see after filter area, there is no slag, but from downthrough to filter, slag is there. So filter has perfectly done his job. Now the defective mishran and cold shut. Cold shut. Shut means you can see the two layers of the metal have been not been completed, joined. There is a line in the two layers of the metal. Next slide. Mishran and cold shut. This is the mishran. Mishran means amount of metal which was required to pour the casting is less. So that's all the level we can see. Level is same. Height wise, level of metal has reached to this particular height. Then amount of metal is finished. So we can say it is a short pour also. This is the cold short pour. This is the mishran and this is also cold shut. Typically line is there, red mark is given, the line is there. So two layers of metal have been not joined or amalgamated in each other. That's why the line is there. Next slide. An incompletely filled mold cavity is termed as mishran. Lugs, corners or thin edges are left unfilled completely. Short run, or another name is mishran. A discontinuity due to imperfect fusion of two streams of metal is termed as cold shut. Next, this is the definition. The remedy, the causes and remedies are almost the same as those for the mishran. Mishran or cold shut. Where to maintain the pouring time, temperature, number of ingot. These are the interrupted pouring also. That also causes interrupted pouring. In case of hand pouring or ladle pouring, once we start the pouring, in any case, the flow of metal from start to end, flow of metal from start to end should be in a proper way and fixed way. Amount of metal up 4 kg to 5 kg per second as per bunch weight of a casting or design system of a particular casting. Next. This is also insufficient metal purity due to low metal temperature, or we can add improper gating system and less carbon equivalent. If carbon is low, silicon is low, chromium is high, then in case of ductile M, percentage Mg, residual Mg, if high, then also mishran is there, cold shut is there. In case of ductile iron, magnesium percentage, residual magnesium, if goes above not 5%, the fluidity is affected. In case of ductile iron, in case of cast iron, less carbon equivalent is also one of the reason. Next, use of sand with high moisture, interrupted interpouring. These are also the reason. Gas interrupted causing disturbance of flow. What I have said ki choke area, mold vent area should be 3 times or 2 times than choke area, so that this gas entrapment will be avoided. Mold and core ship lead to less wall thickness. Cold or wet ladle, metal flow through less number of ingots. Again, it comes to the gating system. Optimum pouring temperature considering section thickness and geometry of a casting. Geometry of a casting means 40 kg flywheel and 40 kg housing. If 40 kg housing is there and cores are more, then where to pouring time has to be low. Pouring temperature should be around 14, 20, but pouring time should be, if weight of casting is around 70 kg, maximum pouring time should be 16 or 18 seconds. Increase the size and number of ingate, locate them properly. Design of gating system considering section thickness, chemistry, choke area, pouring head, distance of last box from furnace. Distance of last box from furnace. You increase number of vent holes so that to get the vent area. Now we'll go to the case study. Importance of gating system calculation. Mind well, this is the very small casting. Name of casting is cylinder head, that is a compressor head. Weight of casting is 1.2 kg. Length, width, height. Grade of metal is Fg 200. 1.2 kg. General wall is 4 mm. Mind well, general wall is 4 mm. Mold box 24-28. Horizontal parted. Then core is shell core, double decker. Number of casting per mold, 24 numbers. 12 numbers in drag, 12 numbers in coke. Next, cold shut was noticed for coupe half castings only. So, diagnosis and root cause analysis. Cold shut line was noticed for coupe half castings only. This was due to improper ratio of gating system. Due to non-pressurized system, metal velocity was insufficient to flow against the gravity. Resulting cold. This is the case study. Pressure on ingate is details of action implemented. Pressure on ingate is achieved by keeping runner area 1.2 times 10 ingate area. Four runner bars were fed separately to achieve uniform distribution of metal flow. Runner bar made taper. Runner bar has to be made taper. Pouring time to be reduced by 2 seconds. Previous 10 to 12 seconds. Now after modification, 8 to 10 seconds. Chemistry and pouring temperature kept unchanged. Region of rejection cold line. Percent rejection 15% total. Rejection cold 9%. After getting modification. Rejection 6%, rejection due to cold 5%. Now we'll see how it is done. I request to go through the table. Downspout diameter, no change. Runner area, there is a change. Runner area, 3 castings and 4 castings. I will explain in the photograph. 240 mm to 540, 4 casting, 720 mm. Ingate area, 3 casting, 600. Mind well, if you see the before, ingate area is 600 mm square and runner bar area is 240 mm. Actually, ingate area should be, runner bar area should be 1.2 times than ingate area. Here we can see it is exactly reverse. total ingate area 800 and runner area 240. What changes I have done? You can see it. Ingate area 450 mm, runner area 600. Ingate area 540 mm square, runner area 720. So runner area from 240, I have made it to 720. But ingate area, previously it was 600, 800, but I reduced it 450 and 600. Why it is reduced? Because weight of casting is just 1.2 kg. But number of ingate area from 600 to 450, but runner area I increased to keep the pressure on ingate. By doing this, non-pressurized gating system is converted into pressurized gating system. Next. Please see this photograph very carefully. These are the three ingates, and other side these are the four ingates, and you can see this is the coke pattern photo. Coke pattern photo, this is the area which we are having the rejection. These are the ingates and runner bar. One more photo in here. This is the drag pattern photo. You can see there is no distribution of metal. Runner bar is left to right. All the runner bar is same. At center, the announce screw is there and it is connected to the two runner bars. There are coke pattern photo for again. Coke pattern photo. Now you can see I have broken the connection of what you say. All the runner bar, instead of two, I have made it four. Are you able to see it? I have broken the connection of runners, so that casting which is having, which feed the runner bar in, runner bar which fed for three casting or four casting, all the runner bar are made separate, so that all the runner bar will get same amount of metal or equal amount of metal from the down screw. This is most important, so that we can have the pressure on ingate. What we have done is ingate area and runner area. Runner area is kept 1.2 times than ingate area, so that pressure on ingate will come. Then metal, it has helped in metal going against the gravity, avoiding the defect. Next. We'll go savings and schedule per month was 20,000 number, weight of casting, total weight per month, number of cost, considering the previous rejection, number of casting would have been rejected with old gating, considered 9%, 1800, 20,000 into 9%, 1800, number of casting actually rejected 100 numbers. So number of casting saved 1700 per month. So this is the metal saved, number of casting due to reduced rejection as per the sale value minus scrap value. These calculations are done. Next. Already we told about the dross. Dross means especially for the slag inclusion for the ductile iron. Dross, that word used for the ductile iron. High percentage of residual magnesium allowing a particular Mg in HAN. All these already things I told. Next. This is the sand drop. You can see the photograph. Sand has been, we are going from some other defect, sand drop. Next. When a portion of sand drops from the top part of the mold or from other overhanging section into mold cavity, defect known as drop, sand drop. Drop means falling from top. These are the causes: weak or improperly rammed mold, rough and careless handling and clamping of molds, worn out patterns or patched up molds, improper design with sharp corners, deep pockets, overhang gear or protruding section, insufficient draft on the pattern, and I can add more, in improper box closing also, or improper length of the closing pin. If core height on cope mold is more, and if you use less height of pins, then there are chances while mold closing, core will touch to the mold and the sand will fall away. Next, poor core print design. This is specifically if core height from parting line is 3 or 4 inches above, then the core should be perfectly vertical, and this can be achieved by perfectly designing the core print, that is handling face of a core and a resting face of core. Those are to be kept separate. If you keep handling face separate and resting face separate, then core remains perfectly vertical. Onion closing bend, bend in closing bend, hitting of boxes, sharp corners, these are the possible causes. Next, proper ramming of holes, careful handling and flapping, avoid sharp corner, ensure use of defect-free closing pin. Defect-free means no bend, use proper oil while closing the pin, so that provide adequate clearance between core print and pattern print. Normally, as a foundry practice, we keep 1 mm clearance on cope mold, so that while closing the box, the defect should not occur. But important thing is, basically, we have to see that proper closing of the box and proper length of the pin. These are the most important towards the center. These are the sand inclusion, undercut, rough surface of core was improper drop closing, mold breakage, rough pattern surface, low grain compression, high sand temperature leading to friability of mold. High and especially in summer, or sand plant which doesn't have the cooler system, or insufficient quantity of the sand storage as per the molding melting capacity. Next. These are also sand inclusion causes: improper mixing of sometimes, worn out melting surface of mold boxes causing poor ramming, poorly repaired mold, careless setting of course, careless cleaning of molds by closing, improper mold and core coating. Worn out melting surface of the mold boxes causing poor ramming. This is also important. If boxes, parting face of the box, which may have the dry sand on vertical, inside vertical of a mold box, that has to be cleaned before using the box on the molding machine. This is also one of the reason that friable sand or dry sand that comes in the casting, then it will have the defect of sand inclusion. Next, sand particles falling into closed mold through risers or rough handling of closed mold, careless fixing of chill sand chaplet, interrupted pouring, slow pouring, excessive material. And one thing I can add, while doing the mold venting in coke box, if the venting is air blowing, if it's not done clearly or in a systematic way, that sand will also fall from the mold vents while clamping or while transferring the box. The small sand will fall in the directly on the casting. Pouring sand inclusion, pouring old molds. Suppose in some bredon is there in the furnace, after 4 hours, if we do the pouring, then this type of defect occurs. Pouring old molds whose surface area is become friable. At least after 2 hours, pouring has to be avoided. Or one thing what we can do, we can close the pouring basin. If you with due care, then air will not enter in the molds. Then sand will not be friable. Avoid badly worn and damaged pattern equipment. Ensure uniform dense compaction of pour. Ensure good location in prints which are large and enough to support the mass of pour. That also design part of a mold pour. Pour at controlled rate of and at constant height. This is most important. While in the track line, distance between the two track line has to be kept sufficient so that 500 kg ladle, if you start the pouring, the height of the, please note, distance between the two tracks has to be kept sufficient, or actually select the ladle from which you are going to do the pouring. Pour the first box level of metal and last box level of metal. At that time, angle of ladle will be changed, and that ladle bottom portion should not touch to the adjacent molding box. And to avoid that, normally what operator does it, he has to lift the ladle on the higher side, so that pouring height will be increased. So while keeping the distance between the two track lines, this type of care has to be taken. Pour at controlled rate from constant height is most important. Otherwise, what happens, box level and pouring height, lip of the pouring ladle will be above coke box height, about 6 inch or sometimes 8 inch happens practically. I have seen it. So that because of less distance between the two tracks, ladle has to be kept up, and that gives the turbulence, sand inclusion defect. That's why I have specifically mentioned pour at controlled rate from a constant height. Now, another important defect in the system is shrinkage. Next. This is a definition. While the material is changing from liquid to solid, contraction takes place at varying rates, which causes irregularly shaped shrinkage cavities or depression. A shrinkage defect is generally uneven hole or spongy area lined with fern-like crystal called dendrites. It can be observed in the microstructure. Shrinkage is jagged hole or spongy area lined with abrupt change. These are the causes. Abrupt changes in section thickness of casting, sharp internal corner or two small fillets in the casting,
directional solidification not care taken care in the design of casting, inadequate risers, improper riser junction, improper ratio of riser neck to casting sides. Abrupt changes in section thickness. This happens especially in the cylindered or water jacketed crankcases, where the mounting hole or upper crankcase and heads are there, where the heads are mounted. That from that bolt hole is passing. In that area, chunky section will be there. But adjacent to that, the thickness will be about 6 mm, 8 mm. That is the abrupt changes. Directional solidification, inadequate riser, improper riser junction, improper ratio of riser neck to casting. Riser neck, please note, riser neck should solidify first. If you calculate the modulus, that has to be taken care of. Riser neck distance from casting should be 15 to 20 mm. Max. It should not be 10 mm, it should not be 25 mm. If the riser neck distance is 25 to 30 mm, in case of ductile iron or gray cast iron also, rejection of shrinkage will be around 10 to 15% or sometimes 20%. But if you keep riser neck sizes and distance properly, then rejection due to shrinkage as per the modulus and other calculation will be zero. If we do not keep the riser neck properly, riser size is also important, but neck is also much important. I have given the specifically the note, 15 mm or 20 mm, not more than that. Distance from casting to riser neck. Next, insufficient chill, poor ramming of molds. Poor ramming of molds means mold wall movement. That is called mold dilation. What is meant by mold dilation? In case of cast iron and AGN, while cooling, while solidifying, carbon gets carbon equivalent or carbon gives while solidifying, it gives pressure on the, it expands carbon equivalent or carbon, free carbon, it expands and it gives pressure on mold wall. At that time, if sufficient mold hardness is not there, then shrinkage will come. That's why all the MNCs, in case of ductile iron, all the MNCs, they specify that we want the casting from the high pressure molding line. This is the most important factor to avoid the shrinkage. Improper clamping, improper placing of weights wherever necessary, improper metal composition, poor inoculation of metal. Mind well, in case of cast iron, if we inoculate more than 0.25%, if we inoculate more, then shrinkage will occur in thick section. Shrinkage will occur in thick section. So, excess inoculation is also not useful. Exact inoculation, 0.2% or 0.22% is sufficient. But size of inoculation has to be choicely corrected. If you are doing hand pouring, 0 to 3 mm. If you are pouring by 250 kg or 500 kg, 3 to 6 mm. If we are doing the pouring by 1-ton ladle, size of inoculation should be 6 to 12 mm. Excessive or inadequate pouring temperature.
for heavy casting, large riser, not repoured for heavy casting, or in case of directly Kalpur sleeves, where to remove the filter, where to remove the filter and where to repour it. In case of ductile iron, direct pouring or gray iron, filter has to be removed and again pouring has to be done. In such sufficient pouring, isolated heavy section which cannot be poured. But this will come under the during development stage, these all the things are to be taken care of. Feed, definitely it has to be taken care of while designing the gating system. Next, during sample production itself, a developer quality plan or control plan incorporating the important parameters like composition, pouring time, temperature, etc. Ensuring stringent control in maintaining the required composition. Pour the casting at appropriate temperature as per quality plan. Segregate the store foundry returns grade wise. During development time, basically, this has to be, nowadays, very good software tools are there, simulation companies are there. They are helping us to calculate or locate the hotspot. If we do proper simulation, then definitely we can avoid the shrinkage, because in that software we get the modulus, filling sequence is there, filling time, how the filling is there, how the casting is getting solidified, all the information we are getting in the simulation software. But our common sense, our foundry practices are to be some of the things we had to add from our own experience. That is also important, especially for HJIN, ductile iron, while doing a design, designing a gating system. I feel that simulation has to be done. With this helps definitely where the hotspot is there. Next, when first samples are poured, check the alignment of neck and riser and wheel. When first samples are poured, check the alignment of necks, riser and wheel. Section of the riser and find out the fitting efficiency. Use external check as and when needed. Next. Maintain good mold vertically if necessary by using pneumatic rammer. Normally, while checking the mold harness, we should check the mold harness at the corner of the box, and vertical mold harness is also important. Only vertical mold harness is important. In case of ARPA molding line, vertical mold harness should be 80 and above. In case of ARPA, vertical mold harness should be 80 minimum. And horizontal harness should be 85 to 90. But it has to be checked from edge around 30 to 40 mm. In that zone only we have to check. If we check the mold harness at center, it is always there. It will always come okay. But it has to be checked on the side of the, nearer to the box edge. Maintain centimeter ratio for cast iron for ductile iron. This is also most important factor. Sand to metal ratio is most important factor for cast iron and one to here. It has to be calculated by using bunch weight and not casting weight. People calculate on the casting weight, but it has to be calculated on the bench weight. Normally, what things happen, if the casting is completely casting in the drag box, we calculate the sand of two box, cope and drag. 100% casting or 80% casting, if it is in the drag box, we have to calculate the sand to metal ratio considering weight of the drag box only or respective box only. Many times this point is skipped. Check metal holding. This is most important. If any bread are there, metal holding is bound to take happen, but where to maintain the temperature of metal around 1300 degrees centigrade, 50 or no, anything above 1400 and holding for 10 minutes or 25 minutes, it's going to create the problem. Carbon equivalent low, pouring temperature high, proper sleeve use. Sleeve used after gap of 10, after opening the packaging, is dangerous. Sleeves are fixed, hence every day new box has to be used. If some of the sleeves from the box are balanced, those are to be kept properly. Those are to be packed properly. That plastic cover which is there, that has to be used for proper packing. In case of direct pour sleeve, filter to be taken up for better feeding. That already I told you. Next. Now the case two. So my request will be, this is the particular defect which I have observed. It is not given in any book. This particular defect is not given in any book. This is the pulley casting. Weight of pulley is around 8 kg. You can see the grooves are there. One groove is there for the pulley. In this particular pulley, we were getting the black spots on the while in that pulley and we were getting black spots in the pulley where the belt is fitting. In that area, we were getting the black spot. These black spots were because of graphite pull-off. Gentlemen, everybody knows in gray cast iron or a ductile iron, free carbon is there. This free carbon, in case of cast iron, that free carbon is getting pulled out. Free carbon is getting pulled out, and we observe that in that area where the graphite is pulled out, shining is not there. And the machine shop gentleman, what we will do, he will take out the casting as a rejection because that block black spot is there. Graphite will be always black. And nowadays CNC VMCs are there. Normally speed feed is high, so that while doing the grooving of the pulley, that groove, while making the groove of the pulley, speed and feed are high. And at that time, because of the high speed and feed, graphite is getting pulled out. And we see that the defect is black spots are there. To avoid graphite pull out, next slide, please. Details of the actions taken to reduce the rejection of shrinkage. Groove porosity was due to graphite pull out. Microstructure checked and found type A and B. Graphite flakes having size 2, 3 and 4. C type flakes were also noticed. I have attached the microstructure. Please see that. Reason is incorrect charge mix. Reason of graphite coming out is because of use of, this was the present charge mix or previous charge mix. peak 15%, MS 20%, returns 50%, boring 15%. But what I had done the change is from peak 15%, I made it 5%, and MS 20%, I made it 25%. So I increased the MS by 5% and reduced the peak by 10%. Due to that, graphite pullout is graphite pullout is not there. We can see the micro after modifying the charge mix, micro checked in which type A was found, size 3 to 5, B 10%, C type traces. 100% C type was found in the traces. We can see this. I request you to please see this microstructure carefully, where the red lines are there. These are the graphite, C-type graphite flakes are there. Thick flakes are there. C-type flakes are there, in which that block spot, that block black spot was getting removed while doing the machining, resulting those black spots and finding the getting the rejection. Next, अजून एक आहे की फोटो, वन मोर फोटो इथे, आय थिंक वन मोर फोटो इज असला, अजून एक आहे. But sorry, gentlemen, another photo is not there, but I will add it. After modifying the charge mix, what was there, that C-type flakes were absent, basically traces were there, and graphite type A was there, size 3 to 5 was there, but thick flakes were not there. Then free carbon pulling, free carbon or graphite pullout during the machining was stopped, and these are the results given atom wise, quantity wise, percentage rejection wise, savings are given, and I'm very happy to say that earlier rejection was around 20%, later the rejection came down to 5%, 6%, but these were the other rejection. But rejection due to graphite pullout was up to 1 to 2% only, 1 to 2%. So this particular defect is there. You can see my sign is there, the boundary measure sign is there, and date is also there. I had done it is on the 2017, 8th of June. 2017. So these were the benefits, saving the benefits. Common criteria or guideline while deciding the corrective action for any defects to be followed: a percent rejection if 10% to 15%, then it is a process control poor, hence rejection. Find out earlier records of the same casting compared to defect wise rejection, not only 10% or 15%, that particular defect rejection has to be compared. If not only, and if rejection is more than 30% or more than 25% for one single defect, for one single defect, blow hole or shrinkage. If defect is percentage reaction due to shrinkage or blow hole, if it is 10 to 12%, it is a process reaction. If it is 30%, then we have to see the methoding. For one single defect, development team to review all parameters, getting chemistry, core, mold, venting, pouring practice. Check shift wise or group wise trend of rejection. This is most important in the foundry, molder or supervisor, some supervisor or molder or shift in charge who is following the process strictly will have less rejection. And one gentleman who is not following the process control will have more rejection. So shift wise or group wise train of rejection has to be always to be taken care of. That always helps in doing the analysis. This is the guideline which I have given basically as per the area was metal and pouring, layout and gating, sand and pour, pattern, and defect wise contribution, how much it is, or where to focus area wise or defect wise. This I have given. This is very useful basically. Thank you, gentlemen. So, any questions are there, please?
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. It's a nice presentation. Any questions? Meantime, I have opened the poll. So, kindly give your feedback on this webinar. And if anybody have any questions, please raise your hand. Deshpande sir, can you go in the chat box also, check up any question?
Yeah, take it. Yes.
Joshi sir, have one question. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Joshi sir,
please, yes. Please.
Do you hear me?
Yes.
I can hear.
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear. Go ahead.
Hello.
You can hear. I can hear. Please.
Okay. I have one question.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes. Go ahead. I can hear. Go ahead.
Deshpande sir, meanwhile there are few questions on the chat box as well.
Hello.
Yes sir, you can go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, I can hear Guruji sir. Bola.
I have one question.
Yes, please.
First of all, I must thank for an exhaustive and never seen before type of rejection analysis given by Deshpande sir. I would say, in fact, he has given the cream of the whole experience of his life into all these lights. And I must thank him for that.
Thank you, sir.
Having said that, I have a doubt.
Yes.
You said that, this pH of the sand is to be maintained between 0.5 to 9. Is that right?
Yes, 8 to 9. Yes.
Hello.
8 to 9.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
No, I can hear you.
I think he has some internet or network problem, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hello. 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 Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, we can hear you. We can hear you.
चॅटबॉक्स मध्ये दोन तीन प्रश्न आहेत. हाऊ हाय टेम्परेचर लिंक्स श्रिंकेज डिफेक्ट
बिकॉज ऑफ हाय टेम्परेचर देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ श्रिंकेजेस आर देयर. वन इज लिक्विड टू लिक्विड.
हॅलो.
देन लिक्विड टू सॉलिड. अँड
सॉलिड. डू यू हियर मी?
येस येस
येस
येस.
हॅलो हॅलो.
Yes, we can hear you.
पर्सनली बोलतो म्हणून सांगा किंवा तसं मेसेज करा.
ठीक.
येस 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 येस
येस. हाय 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 टेम्परेचर अँड श्रिंकेज लिंकेजेस.
हाय श्री. देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ श्रिंकेज. लिक्विड टू लिक्विड, लिक्विड टू सॉलिड अँड सॉलिड टू सॉलिड. So liquid to liquid, if temperature is there, high temperature, so it will have a more effect on shrinkage. Liquid to shrinkage is more. So that's why if you pour at high temperature, basically you can see the depression on the casting. Depression on the casting. If pouring temperature is high, then there will be a depression on the casting. Liquid to liquid shrinkage is always high as compared to liquid to solid and solid to solid. Three types of shrinkage are there.
Is any more questions there? No. No questions in the chat box as well. Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you very much for your nice presentation. And hope everybody has enjoyed it and got some information how to go for defect analysis and how the actions can be initiated. Basically, analysis is very important before we go for action. So, both things, how to analyze and how to take action, both are been good explained by Deshpande sir. Thank you very much for your presentation and time. With this, we conclude this presentation. Thank you very much for joining and participating. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you all the participants.
Thank you. Thank you for listening.